looks around, he sees all the people that he had been working with over the years for a long time. They're gone. He's got to be the final one to close the door on the way out.
Coaching staff is gone. He's so big on continuity and stability. This organization has been about staying the course, not even in a different direction. Hard to imagine him going over the page.
One of the greatest quarterbacks of all time, one of the most popular quarterbacks of all time, is getting shoved out the door by the franchise he ever wanted to play for.
Icon of the franchise, the quarterback of the franchise, a guy you owe $28 million to come March 8th. You guys haven't even spoken about his future within your organization. That, to me, was a telltale sign, very much like Mr. Kravitz said, that they've already moved on.
When I got off the phone with him, I turned to my wife and I said, he knows it's over. He knows he's not coming back.
All right, that's a lot of what people are saying on Peyton Manning. The last person you heard from is a very plugged-in man in Indianapolis' sports scene. That's Bob Kravitz. He's a columnist for the Indianapolis Star, and he has come to the conclusion that Peyton is done in Indianapolis. He has taken his final snap with the Colts. If that's the case, and he is about to be released before that March 8th doomsday deadline, if he's headed out, where's the best fit? What's the next page for Peyton Manning?
I know. I already know where you're going.
The New York Jets.
Oh, I thought you had another one.
The New York Jets. There is no question. I would say the Washington Redskins, but I don't know how comfortable it would be for Peyton Manning to have to, you know, play against his little brother twice a year. Just a circus that the Mannings don't seem inclined to participate in. But I think about the New York Jets, and it's no disrespect, even though Mark Sanchez with his sensitive self will take it this way. I mean no disrespect to him. He got better statistically this year, even though there were some issues between him and San Antonio Holmes. The reality is that I think Mark Sanchez will ultimately be a much better quarterback in this game, and he's had some great moments. But he's no Peyton Manning. He never will be. And if you have an opportunity to bring Peyton Manning to New York City, to Gotham City, okay, with the weapons that they could potentially have. I mean, he's a game manager. You know that Rex Ryan really focuses on the defense, and even though the defense took a step back this year, they were still one of the top 10 defenses in the game. So you got to believe they're going to improve upon that. They need a general. They have problems with their quarterback. They got a problem with their offensive coordinator, and Brian Schottenheimer is gone now. Mm-hmm. But guess what? You won't have that problem at all if you bring in Peyton Manning, because he'll be both.
He will be.
He'll be both. So to me, it is an easy call right there. There is no doubt you go with the one and only Peyton Manning.
Completely agree with you. I already wrote down Jets.
Where did you think he was going to go? Because you thought he was going somewhere else.
I thought he was going to the Rockies.
I thought he was. See, we were thinking the same way. I thought he was going to Mile High.
Yeah, that's right. I must say, Mile High is my dream scenario. I would love to see Denver acquire Peyton Manning and trade Tim Tebow to the Jacksonville Jaguars, or cut Tim Tebow and let him go to Jacksonville. Yeah. Either way,
I would love Tim Tebow in Jacksonville too, but I'll tell you why in a second.
Okay, because Jacksonville would unleash. And you'd see the real Tebow. You'd see more of the Tebow that I wanted to see all year in Denver, because that staff would handle him a lot different. It would be a whole new regime. They would actually want him to play. They would actually support him from week to week. But the problem is, would Peyton Manning want to go play with a team that has one receiver and no defense? Because that's what Tim Tebow was stuck with all year and had to overcome. No, he would not want to play there. I'm sorry, he would not. It's silver platter, Jets, Gotham City, weapons, still a pretty good nut. It's the defense and what it was.
They'll get it better. I say they'll make it better again.
They will. I agree. I think you could win pretty quickly. You have a shot to win it all next year. Let Peyton run the whole offense. Just say, here, you
How do you think he would play with Rex Ryan?
I don't know. The better question is, how would Rex play with him?
Well, the dynamic of the two of them. If he came there, Rex Ryan, with all of his bluster and bloviating, Rex Ryan would shut up. Because
I'm with you.
Because Rex Ryan was trying to pump guys up to exceed expectations. But once the expectations were legitimized, meaning the arrival of Peyton Manning, I think you'll see him be a bit more demure, a bit timid, because he know that if they didn't get it done, it would be all
on him. You said that the Mannings aren't big in jumping into the circus atmosphere, which you'd have if he was in the division with
you. In the division with
you. What about in the city?
In the city, that's different. Because, you know, you're going to get the attention no matter what because you're a Manning and you're great. But the point is that that's entirely different than you having to go up against your little brother, because that means somebody loses every year. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying?
Can you imagine
don't really
the back page?
And you don't really want to deal with that.
Peyton Brady twice a year?
Unreal.
And by the way, the Tebow thing about going to Jacksonville, let me tell you something about him going to Jacksonville. He goes to Jacksonville, they probably wouldn't want him either. He'd be in the same situation. You know why? Because the popularity contest that existed in Denver for him would be existing in Jacksonville even more. So they'd be under more pressure. They'd be under more pressure, okay? And once again, he'd get exposed. Let's move on.
You mean they might actually win?
Let's move on.
Let's take a break. When we come back, Penn State says goodbye.